The Avengers were created in 1963 by Marvel Comics legends Stan Lee and Jack Kirby. Consisting of characters that had already debuted in their own standalone titles, the original lineup included Iron Man, Thor, the Hulk, Ant-Man, and the Wasp. The team, dubbed Earth's Mightiest Heroes, first formed in response to a threat from Loki. After defeating the Asgardian villain, the five founding members pledged to combine their special powers and unite for the greater good. Unlike in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, however, neither S.H.I.E.L.D. nor Nick Fury had anything to do with the creation of the team. In what would become standard operating procedure for the Avengers, the lineup began to change right away. The Hulk left by issue 2, Ant-Man became Giant Man, and Captain America joined in Avengers number 4. Cap had first debuted in 1941, before Marvel Comics was even called Marvel Comics. Lee and Kirby were reintroducing an old popular favorite. By 1965, the first major overhaul of the membership occurred. Everyone but Cap stepped down, with new members Hawkeye, Quicksilver, and the Scarlet Witch joining. This incarnation, dubbed Cap's Kooky Quartet, was interesting in that the new Avengers had all previously played the role of villains. Hawkeye's mentor, the Swordsman, soon joined as well, for just one issue. His membership turned out to be a ruse by the Iron Man villain, the Mandarin. Though he would rejoin the team in 1973 as a full-fledged member and hero. In the late 60s, founding members would return to the fold and then leave again, even while new heroes continued to join. This included the Olympian Hercules and the first mainstream superhero of color, the Black Panther, who had earlier debuted in the Fantastic Four. Writer Roy Thomas also introduced the android Avenger, the Vision, and the Black Knight during this period. Many of Thomas's stories were drawn by the artist John Buscema, and together they brought a grand sense of the mythological to the book, as well as a more adult sensibility. As the team entered the 1970s, such characters as Black Widow would become long-lasting members, while others such as the time-traveling cowboy, the Two-Gun Kid, and Mantis enjoyed shorter terms of service. The 70s also introduced a few very influential storylines, such as the cosmic epic The Kree-Skrull War, and writer Jim Shooter's stories like The Bride of Ultron and the Korvac Saga. The fight against Michael Korvac was another huge adventure for the team that utilized virtually every Avenger past and present up to that point, as well as the original Guardians of the Galaxy. Later on, notable additions to the team were Wonder Man in 1977 and Carol Danvers in 1979. At the time, she was still operating under the Miss Marvel guise and was several decades away from becoming Captain Marvel. Another character that Marvel movie watchers may recognize is the Falcon, Captain America's partner from the era. The early 80s saw a number of women join the team, women like Tigra, who started out as a human crime fighter named the Cat, but eventually transformed with the help of sorcery. Bruce Banner's cousin, Jennifer Walters, who became the She-Hulk after a blood transfusion with Bruce's blood. And an all-new Captain Marvel named Monica Rambeau, who later went by the names Photon and Spectrum. In 1984, the first of what would eventually be many offshoots of the main Avengers team arrived when the Vision suggested the creation of the West Coast Avengers. Hawkeye led the first iteration of this team, which also drafted new members like his wife Mockingbird, aka former S.H.I.E.L.D. agent Bobby Morse, and Tony Stark's friend James Rhodes, who was serving as Iron Man at the time. Rhodes would later become War Machine, and even later, Iron Patriot. Other characters would also join the different Avengers teams around this time. Namor finally joined up with the Avengers, while Thing joined the West Coast Avengers. Both teams would operate simultaneously for a decade, each acquiring new heroes for their respective and, at times, interchangeable lineups. But in the East Coast book, the team fell on hard times during the Under Siege story that began in 1986 under the writer Roger Stern. As the main Avengers book approached its 300th issue, the East Coast group's downward spiral culminated with the entire team disbanding in 1988. Of course, the Avengers couldn't stay apart for long, and soon Steve Rogers, known at the time simply as the Captain, built a new team that included Reed and Sue Richards from the Fantastic Four, as well as Gilgamesh, the hero of legend. Speaking of the Captain, when Rogers gave up the Captain America name, the mantle was passed over to John Walker, who eventually became the U.S. agent. The decade was rounded out with the additions of both Quasar and the Human Torch. This Human Torch was not Johnny Storm, but rather a character that first appeared in 1939.